Well, there's an old saying, it's not a matter of if you will face adversity, rather when. Damian Williams is living his childhood dream, but a football career can be a winding path. Luckily for him, his faith and his family have been steady guides since the beginning. Spend a little time with David Williams.
This is actually a touchdown shot.
And you'll see a very proud father.
This is his jersey of the Emerald Bowl, that he wore at the Emerald Bowl, and his gloves he was wearing.
And it's hard to blame him. For the last 2 years, his son has been doing this on a national stage.
Holy cow. Damian Williams, the most dangerous receiver on this field.
Damian Williams is on the verge of fulfilling a lifelong dream, playing in the NFL.
I've always wanted to do this, and so I know that on draft day, it's going to be very emotional for me.
But the journey has been long and winding, full of mountaintops and valleys. And it began in his hometown, Springdale, Arkansas.
I guess we can sum it up as saying awesome. It was an awesome year. It was outstanding.
In 2005, Springdale High football was a national phenomenon, a team loaded with Division I stars, and Damian Williams was perhaps the brightest one.
He had it in high school. I mean, he had those ingredients of being a tremendous athlete, a difference maker with the ball in his hands.
There was little question the Bulldogs would win the state championship. What everyone really wanted to know, where was Damian going to college?
Touchdown, Arkansas! Damian Williams has his first career touchdown as an Arkansas Razorback.
David and Karen Williams have always told their son that everything happens for a reason. In 2006, he made the SEC's all-freshman team, but didn't feel like the Hog offense was making the best use of his ability, so he was looking to transfer. As fate would have it, the season opener was against Southern Cal. And when Trojan coaches went back and looked at the game film, they were impressed with Damian Williams. And once word got back to L.A. that he was looking to transfer, things fell into place quickly.
What would it take for him to go to University of Southern Cal? And I simply said, a scholarship. And he said, that's all? I said, an offer and he'll be there. And the rest was history.
Moving out there by myself and being so far away from home, it kind of forced me to mature and to grow up. Maybe faster than most people do.
Having to sit out a year might be frustrating for someone who's been playing and starting his whole life, but Williams just used it to his advantage.
Damian is a film junkie.
Student of the game.
And definitely a student of the game.
It was not like in Arkansas where everybody knew who Damian Williams was. In Southern Cal, he was just another recruit that transferred in. So he had to prove himself.
Steps away. Second touchdown catch of the night.
Once he actually hit the field, Damian was hitting on all cylinders. He led the Trojans in receptions and yardage in 2008 and set the stage for an even bigger 2009. Over 1,000 yards and even returned a couple of punts for scores. Damian Williams had blossomed into an elite college receiver.
He's got the ticker. He's got the heart, man. He's got the drive. And he don't care what the naysayers say. He's going to go out and do what he does, and he's going to do it at a high level.
And now that lanky Springdale kid who dreamed of the NFL is standing on its doorstep, gearing up for the combine and the NFL draft.
I've been through so much as a player, and, you know, even a time where I didn't even know if I was going to play football to, you know, now I'm here, and, you know, finally I can just say I made it.
He didn't accomplish all those things on his own. It was only through his belief and through God's help that he is where he is today, and that's just not something I want him to forget.
Touchdown! No